Hello, everybody. Welcome to Good Evening KU. This is our first show that we've done, so it might be a little bit short tonight, but we'll have a good show for you. There's a lot going on the KU campus tonight. We've got basketball senior night going on. It'll be live at 8 p.m. on ESPN.
I saw the line outside Allen Fieldhouse. It is insane. I would not want to be standing out there because it doesn't look like most people are even going to get in.
But we are going to be your hosts tonight. My name is Bella.
And I'm Maddie.
And we're going to talk about some celebrity news.
All right. So all me and my friends have been talking about lately is this Selena Gomez and Hailey Bieber drama. Have you heard about any of it?
I've heard some of it. I know Selena Gomez was on a commenting rampage on TikTok and stuff earlier.
But and I know that Hailey has been on a TikTok rampage making fun of Selena.
Gotcha. See, I have mixed feelings about it because I'm a little bit over the whole Hailey versus Selena thing. But I understand that they were shading each other. So, like, you got to stick up for it, you know?
But because I know Hailey has kind of because she's not making direct fun of Selena in all of these TikToks and stuff that she's doing, but it's always implied that who she's talking about is Selena, because a lot of times Selena posts something and Hailey posts something about someone and she doesn't name who it is, which is in reference to something Selena has recently done.
Gotcha. Well, also, I heard that there are rumors that Shawn Mendes and Sabrina Carpenter are dating because they were seen having a nice outing in LA, which is really interesting. Given their past relationships.
Yeah, I was about to say, like, wasn't Sabrina Carpenter just in a whole slew of drama between all the High School Musical, the musical, the serious people?
Olivia Rodrigo, all that drama. And Shawn Mendes just broke up with Camila Cabello like a year ago.
I thought they were supposed to be some power couple or something.
You know, love is dead.
Apparently in Hollywood it is.
Yes, but we are going to bring it back to local KU. I didn't get a chance to go to Rock Chalk Review, did you? Because I want to hear about it.
I went to Rock Chalk Review on their opening night this past Thursday, and it was just amazing. Like, the talent that all of these college kids bring, like, making their own sets, costumes, stories, it's like, I could never do it, but now after watching with all my friends, we all want to try out next year because it was so fun to watch.
Cool, that's super fun. All right, well, we've got a great show going for you tonight. We're going to have some news and some updates on the weather, so keep watching, and we'll see you guys later.
We had another warmer day today, and it was great seeing everyone on campus, and it's perfect weather for the big men's basketball game tonight. Tomorrow will be a bit cooler with a high of 56 and a low of 31, and it will be a bit less windy with gusts only up to 9 miles per hour. We can expect some scattered showers on Thursday as it continues to cool down, and possibly snow on Friday, so be extra careful driving on K-10 as it did have to close in part last week due to the icy conditions. This weekend, it will start to slowly warm back up again despite the clouds, with an unexpected high of 64 on Sunday. Next week, we can expect a few days of full of rain, ice, and possible flurries, so enjoy this weather while it lasts.
And I'm Sophia. This is your Tuesday Good Evening KU News Update. In recent news, Kansas City International Airport opened its four-year-long, highly anticipated $1.5 billion single terminal renovation today, just in time for spring break. The new single terminal will replace the original airport that opened in 1972. The airport features local Kansas City brands and businesses, including 50 restaurants and shops. It will also feature the largest public art program in Kansas City history, worth $5.6 million worth of newly commissioned art. Is anyone else going to miss those iconic floors inside MCI?
Rock Chalk Review took place at the Lead Center this past weekend and made huge strides for charity. $31,000 raised in monetary donations went to the Willow Domestic Violence Center, supporting victims of domestic violence here in Lawrence. Each year, sorority and fraternity chapters pair up with each other to produce a 20-minute long show with songs and dances, all for philanthropic benefit. This year's theme was Go Big or Go Home, and the pairings included Alpha Chi Omega and Beta Theta Pi with Paint the Town, Chi Omega and Delta Tau Delta with One Night in Naismith, Pi Beta Phi and Sigma Phi Epsilon with Step Right Up, Kappa Kappa Gamma and Kappa Sigma with Fieldhouse Rock, and Sigma Kappa and Kappa Delta, who took home the Best in Show trophy with their show En Vogue.
Jimmy Kimmel will host for the third time the 95th annual Oscars on Sunday, March 12th. The show will include performances from Sophia Carson, Diane Warren, and Super Bowl halftime performer Rihanna. Some nominations for Best Picture include Elvis, Top Gun Maverick, and Black Panther: Wakanda Forever. The show will be held at the Dolby Theater in Los Angeles.
KU announced their important dates for the fall 2023 semester. These dates will all take place during the home football season. These events include Family Day, Homecoming Weekend, Salute to Service, and Senior Day. Now for some more weather.
Good evening, KU. So let's take a look at our weather for the upcoming week. So into the next week, we're going to have temperatures feeling warmer than normal with a chance of rain and snow mixture that we'll talk about coming in on Thursday and Friday. And then we're going to finish the week with some clear and skies. So this is the look outside at Lawrence right now. It's looking good. Sun setting. Games going on tonight if you're out there. And these are our current temperatures across the board. So we are at 64 right now. Temperatures are going to continue to drop just a little bit into the evening, but they're still going to stay pretty good throughout the day. We have tonight's forecast. We're going to be in the low 50s, upper 40s, clear skies. So if you're out there enjoying the game, weather's going to look great for you. And then here's a look at our satellite right now. Really clear, some dust coming in, but so far looks great. And then if we look at tomorrow's forecast, we're going to have a high of 58 with sunny. It's going to be pretty calm, zero chance of rain, some slight winds coming out of the north, but overall pretty good day tomorrow. So this is our hourly forecast. Around 8 a.m. a little bit of clouds while you're heading out to classes, and then quickly those are going to clear out. It's going to be sunny for the rest of the day, ending in about 56 degrees. Very subtle wind coming out from the northwest. And then moving into our extended forecast, we have we're going to start with some clouds on Wednesday, and then Thursday and Friday we're going to have some rain. Friday's going to be when we have our wintry mix going on, and then that's going to clear out very quickly into Saturday, and we're going to finish the weekend with temperatures in upper 40s, lower 50s, and then continuing into our next week, pretty good temperatures back into the 60s for the rest of the week. So that's all we have for you here tonight, and join us here next week at the same time. Thanks.